Could a lion pride survive in the Cretaceous? Lions are alphas of the African continent, some of the most feared animals on the planet, yet there was a time when they would have been insignificant little nothings. Lions are estimated to have come about on this planet 500,000 years ago, but over 66 million years ago was the Cretaceous period. Drop a lion pride in that time period, how do you think they do? A lion is currently king of the jungle, but would he be just a pawn in the Cretaceous period? The lion's qualities and habitat. Although there is a small subspecies of Indian lion that lives in the forests of northwest India, most lions in the world inhabit Africa. From the southern portions of the Sahara Desert to northern South Africa, that is the swath of earth that lions live and dominate. Lions inhabit open plains, thick brush, and dry thorn forests mainly. They are fairly adaptable in the drier regions. There aren't many animals in the world that can thrive in deserts, but lions can. They exist in prides, operating like a well-trained team, strategizing, hunting their prey, and taking them down. The average female lion is about 5 to 6 feet long and weighs 250 to 400 pounds. The average male lion is about 6 to 8 feet long and weighs about 350 to 600 pounds. Lions have massive canine teeth that aren't quite so sharp. They're blunted, used to grip and strangle its prey. They have molars and premolars on the upper and lower jaws, known as carnassials, that act together as razor-sharp scissors to cut the meat. Lions' main prey are larger animals, weighing between 100 to 1,000 pounds, like zebras and wildebeest. If times are desperate, they will also eat smaller animals like rodents and small reptiles, but it isn't preferred. So, in present day, lions are enormous animals, powerful and equipped with weapons in their mouths. They are dominant and confident, they are intelligent, they are not to be trifled with. In present day, the Cretaceous period. Let's rewind back through history, to a period of time 145 million to 66 million years ago, known as the Cretaceous period. The Earth was warmer then versus today, but lions exist well in the heat, so if we placed a pride of lions back in the Cretaceous period, they'd be all right with the temperature. But the temperature would be far from their biggest concern. As you are well aware, plenty of dinosaurs existed in the Cretaceous period. In fact, the predominant class of animals on Earth was the reptiles, and of course, dinosaurs were the biggest of all the reptiles. They were the kings of the planet back then. There were pterodactyls soaring through the skies. The largest of them was Quetzalcoatlus, whose wingspan could reach up to 36 feet long. Remember, the largest lions reach about 8 feet in length. Lions don't currently have to worry about any attacks coming from the skies. They are far larger than any airborne birds. Lions would be no match for the reptiles of the sky in this period, but a pride of lions is cunning. They may be able to work together to keep their eyes on the sky and remain safe. Land predators. But even if the pride of lions worked as a high-functioning unit, the skies were the least of their concerns. It was what would be joining them on the land. Lions are used to being the apex predators, and though they share their habitats with other predators currently, such as hyenas, they outmuscle the other predators. This wouldn't be the case. Depending when in the Cretaceous period you plopped this unfortunate pride of lions down in, they may see the likes of the Spinosaurus or the famous Tyrannosaurus Rex. T-Rex was around 40 feet long and 12 feet tall, weighing somewhere between 11,000 and 15,000 pounds. Spinosaurus was estimated to be about 49 feet long and over 16,000 pounds. So that 8-foot-long lion, though paired up with the others in his pride, would be staring down a reptile that was at least 5 times his size. Not only were both of these predators going to claim the prey in the immediate area, and the lions would have to cede control, the lions may fall victim to becoming prey themselves. They'd no longer be the largest predator, and they'd fall to becoming prey for the first time in their lives. That would be a massive adjustment for these felines. Their strategies would divert from 100% of the time being on the attack to a combination of being on the attack, being on the defensive, and scouting areas to find food where the other, larger predators wouldn't be found. Now, lions have proven to be adaptable in this day and age. They are intelligent hunters and intelligent beings in general. There's a chance they'd adapt. They could use their hunting and detection skills not only for locating food, but for locating adversaries that they were no match against. Just as they remain hidden in long grasses today, waiting for the perfect moment to strike their prey, they could potentially do the same with the dinosaurs. Use their excellent skills in staying hidden to avoid their new predators and relocate to safer areas. Their new diet. Now, let's assume the pride of lions has kept their eyes on the skies for pterodactyls and such, and they've managed to avoid running in too close to the T-Rexes and Spinosauruses. The next step would be to get food. Remember, their favorites were larger herbivores between 100 to 1,000 pounds, like zebras and wildebeest. Obviously, those animals didn't exist, but there were still plenty of herbivores in the Cretaceous period. The problem is, most of them were enormous. Let's forget about sauropods that existed in the Cretaceous period, like titanosaurs, 80 to 100 feet in length, 65 to 85 tons. No lion would be taking them down. They're looking for a 1,000-pound animal, not a 150,000-pound animal. Other herbivores during this period included Ankylosaurus, 10,000 pounds and armored, completely out of the question. There were Triceratops, 25,000 pounds with horns on its head. That would be like messing with a rhino, but 12 times as heavy. That's a no-go. But even T-Rex likely didn't mess with those dinosaurs much. Some easier herbivores for T-Rex to pick off were hadrosaurs and iguanodons. Now we're talking lions. How do they measure up? Well, even the smallest iguanodons were about 8,000 pounds, and the smallest hadrosaurs were 4,000 pounds. That's still four times bigger than what lions would prefer to be attacking. That's no easy meal for any pride of lions. The problem in the Cretaceous period wouldn't have been lack of herbivores, lack of prey. It would have been a lack of those that weren't towering over the lions. Also, reptiles aren't usually a lion's first choice of meal. And when it comes to mammals in the Cretaceous period, there weren't many large ones. In fact, lions would have easily been the largest land mammals. Paleontologists have stated that basically every animal larger than 1 meter in size at this time would have been a dinosaur. There were small mammals, rodents and such. The pride of lions could feast on those, as they currently do in desperate times. There also would have been smaller dinosaurs and reptiles for the lions, but this would create a huge shift in their diet. No more large mammals for the pride of lions to take down and eat in their group. They'd likely be relying more on finding smaller animals, less large meals every once in a while, more smaller snacks, having to eat more frequently. It's tough to say if a pride of lions could make it in the Cretaceous period. There would be a lot of adapting required by them. Lions could no longer operate under the assumption they are, by and large, the apex predator. They'd be far from the apex predator. And they'd, in fact, be a combination of both predator and prey. That would require a complete change of the lion's mindset. The pride of lions would need to be far more cautious. Not just cautious so as not to scare off a meal, cautious so as not to become a meal. Watching the land for predators, watching the skies for predators. Hey, they'd even have to be more careful around water sources. Everything was bigger back then, even the aquatic animals. There were giant marine reptiles back then. And yes, there were crocodiles, much bigger than they are today. The giant crocodilians in the North American regions could get up to 33 feet long. That's about 1.5 times the size they are today. The poor pride of lions even has to be careful just when they're getting a drink of water. The diet of the lions would have to shift. The frequency in which they ate would increase, causing them to expend more energy. If lions were to continue existing in this time period, they'd likely evolve into smaller versions of themselves, just so that they'd have less caloric necessities. Or maybe they'd get much larger to be able to compete with the dinosaurs. All we know is that lions would absolutely have to adapt. The question is, could they adapt enough?